Before we get started, there's something that we need to cover, right, Karen?
That's right, Bill. Before working on a pump, always follow the complete safety and operating instructions in the installation and maintenance manual.
And don't forget the required personal protective safety equipment. Use of this safety equipment is mandatory.
In addition to the precautions that come with your pump, you must always follow the recommendations of the chemical manufacturer or the material safety data sheet and check local codes for additional guidelines.
Preparing the metering pump for service can vary by application, but in general will consist of the following steps. Pump a compatible buffer solution through the pump for several minutes to clean the chemical from the lines. Turn the motor on-off switch to the off position, which is down or to the rear of the pump. Disconnect the suction line from the pump tube suction fitting labeled in the pump head cover. Before disconnecting the discharge side, bleed off any pressure. Then, disconnect the discharge line from the pump tube discharge fitting, labeled out on the pump head cover. Unplug the power cord. If the power cord plug end has been removed, modified, or the metering pump has been directly wired, do not continue. Consult an electrician to aid in disconnecting the pump from the electrical supply and to properly reconnect the pump's electrical supply. To remove the pump head, hold the pump securely, grasp the head, and turn it clockwise until it stops. Remove the tube housing and roller assembly together by pulling it straight out from the pump. The shaft will remain in the pump. Discard the tube, housing, and cover. Put the new pump head onto the motor and turn it counterclockwise until the shaft falls into place. Push the pump head in while turning it counterclockwise. Line up the rivet holes on the pump head with the rivets on the motor. Continue to push until the rivets are inside the holes. Turn the pump head counterclockwise to secure the rivets in the rivet slots, firmly attaching the pump head. Fixed output models manufactured after April 2011 are identified by the key slot in the rear of the motor housing. With the cover latched, plug the pump in and turn it on. Allow the pump to run the roller assembly in its collapsed position for approximately 1 minute to relax the tube. Turn the pump off and unplug the power cord. Remove the tube housing cover and flip to use as a tool to expand the roller assembly. The roller assembly needs to be expanded so the tube is pressed against the tube housing wall. Slide one latch out to remove it from the tube housing. Insert the latch end into the key slot in the vent in the rear of the motor housing. Align the center of the inverted cover with the center of the roller assembly so that the three holes on the face of the cover align with the three knurled lugs on the roller assembly. Position the cover feet near the bottom. While pressing the latch in the vent in the rear of the motor housing, gently rotate the cover clockwise until it stops. Holding the pump securely, use the cover as a wrench and quickly snap, rotate the roller assembly clockwise to expand the roller assembly. The tube will be pressed against the tube housing wall. Remove the latch from the vent and reattach it to the tube housing. Place the tube housing cover feet first on the tube housing. Affix the front of the latches to the cover lip and then press the latches back to secure. To center the tube, ensure the pump is off. Lift the latch located between the tube fittings, leaving the end of the latch engaged with the lip on the tube housing cover. Leave the latch on the opposite side engaged. Plug the pump in and turn it on. Turn the tube fitting on the suction side, not more than 1/8 of a turn in the direction the tube must move. Do not let go of the fitting until the tube rides approximately in the center of the rollers. Then turn the pump off, let go of the fitting, and secure the latch between the fittings. Turn the pump on and verify operation. With the cover latched, plug the pump in and turn it on. Allow the pump to run the roller assembly in its collapsed position for approximately 1 minute to relax the tube. Turn the pump off and unplug the power cord. remove the tube housing cover, and flip to use as a tool to expand the roller assembly. The roller assembly needs to be expanded so the tube is pressed against the tube housing wall. Warning: only the Stenner fan brake tool should be used for this step. Insert the fan brake tool into the vent in the rear of the motor housing. The fixed rate pump doesn't have a clutch, so the fan brake keeps the shaft from rotating when expanding the roller assembly. Align the center of the inverted cover with the center of the roller assembly so that the three holes on the face of the cover align with the three knurled lugs on the roller assembly. Position the cover feet near the bottom. Holding the pump securely, use the cover as a wrench and quickly snap. Rotate the roller assembly clockwise to expand the roller assembly. The tube will be pressed against the tube housing wall. Remove the fan brake tool. Place the tube housing cover, feet first, on the tube housing. Affix the front of the latches to the cover lip and then press the latches back to secure. To center the tube, ensure the pump is off. Lift the latch located between the tube fittings, leaving the end of the latch engaged with the lip on the tube housing cover. Leave the latch on the opposite side engaged. Plug the pump in and turn it on. Turn the tube fitting on the suction side, not more than 1/8 of a turn in the direction the tube must move. Do not let go of the fitting until the tube rides approximately in the center of the rollers. Turn the pump off, let go of the fitting, and secure the latch between the fittings. Turn the pump on and verify operation.